एक्चुअली मेरे बॉम्बे में मुंबई में फर्स्ट मास्टर क्लास है. आई हैव डन अ मास्टर क्लास इन द गोवा फिल्म फेस्टिवल एंड ऑल. आई थिंक इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट कि हम जाएं और अपना टाइम दें ऐसे क्लासेस स्पेशली एट फेस्टिवल्स, बिकॉज बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ सिनेमा दे डोंट गेट अ चांस टू नो हाउ समथिंग. एवरी टाइम वी डू एन इंटरव्यू इट्स ऑल अबाउट आवर पर्सनल लाइफ और इट्स अबाउट गॉसिप और इट्स अबाउट आपने ये स्टार ने ये किया और कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी. बट एक्चुअली नो द प्रोसेस ऑफ फिल्म मेकिंग. How do you shoot a song? How, what are the technicalities? What are the difficulties? How do you solve? I think it's important for us also. It's refreshing when we ask questions only about our craft and not about the personal life.
Okay. और पर आज के इवेंट में लाइक गेस्ट्स बहुत सारे आ रहे हैं, बट बॉलीवुड के कोई गेस्ट नजर नहीं आ रहा.
नहीं, आई थिंक बॉलीवुड के गेस्ट दे नो एवरीथिंग, दे डोंट नीड अ मास्टर क्लास.
ओके.
हाँ, दिस इज बेसिकली फॉर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ सिनेमा. सो इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट वी from Bollywood go and do these classes. And I've said for my entire fraternity sorority bhai aur mere behen jo bhi hain ki wo jaye aur it's good ke hum ye free mein karte hain, hum apna time dete hain, so that students who love movies and who are studying cinema get to do this.
Thank you.
मैं तो पहली बार ही यहाँ पे आया हूँ. मुझे अर्लियर आई वॉज नॉट अवेयर ऑफ इट एंड बट आई एम रियली लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू हैव अ लुक एंड फॉर मैम इज हियर. सो विल बी रियली हैप्पी टू सी हर गिविंग यू नो नॉलेज टू अस एंड टू सी समथिंग डिफरेंट टुडे. क्या और क्या होने वाला आगे, लेट्स सी.
व्हाट इज इन दैट जो इंटरनेशनल लेवल तक वो ये मास्टर क्लास गया था, वो दिस इंडिया मुंबई में भी ये पॉसिबल है.
सी देखो, ऐसी कोई भी चीज़ नहीं है जो इम्पॉसिबल होती है. आई फील हर चीज़ अगर आप मेहनत करो तो पॉसिबल होती है. और अगर कुछ कुछ बड़े लोग भी और कई लोग जो सोच लेते हैं, ठान लेते हैं कि हाँ ये चीज़ करनी ही है, तो वो चीज़ कहीं भी पहुँच सकती है यार. सो आई फील यू नेवर नो.
सो आपकी कोई न्यू क्लेम आने वाली
है? अभी तो फिलहाल एक ही आ रही है और वो है 13 मई को आ रही है अज़र, जिसमें मैं भी मेरा भी एक इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल है. सो आई आई बी रियली हैप्पी इफ़ यू गाइस विल गो एंड वॉच द फिल्म, क्योंकि फिल्म को भी फायदा होगा तो हमें भी कहीं ना कहीं फायदा होगा यार. और शुरुआत में ऐसे ही होता है तो कोई बात नहीं. सो बट डू वॉच. ओके.
No assistant, no nothing, no Nagra, everything I will do.
Is that very important?
It does. The team is important. It's like telling a cameraman, now you have a camera and you go and shoot. There's no lightman to play, like hold the light, or there's no one, no assistant to help you. Luckily I met Shahrukh and he decided he's going to be my assistant. And he still does that. So he would help out, you know, and there was no dancers. They didn't have money for dancers, so they would take local Goan people who didn't know Hindi, and they all had to sing that Chalo Bijo Hua Jaga. They couldn't sing, so Shahrukh would make them stand in a line and practice with them, singing all of them. Yeah, it was literally like that, but I thought those were some of the best songs that I've done, because they were just so innocent and, you know, that. I think as we become more and more expert at our craft somewhere, we are that, you know, sometimes I feel that when I go, I know how I'm going to shoot this song, you know, I know how I'm going to cut this song. And though that is a good thing to have a hold on your craft, but somewhere you become smart. I don't do too many songs. And I don't make too many movies. So I think somewhere that whole thing of becoming a factory hasn't happened as yet for me. Now, luckily, I'm in a position where I choose what I want to do. Someone wants me to do a song. It's my decision. Earlier, it was like, oh my God, I'm getting a song to do and I'm going to get paid 5,000 rupees for it. You know, let's do it. So,
half an hour before we come to Sheena Ki Diwani.
Oh my God. Okay.
My name is Sangeeta. I actually want to ask something about the beginning of your career.
Yeah.
One of the finest things that you had was your technical sense. Shooting.
I can't hear you.
Your
Sangeeta, my little.
Sorry. Yeah. Sorry. Technical sense. Like you shot.
One of the finest things I had.
You have.
Or have.
But in the beginning, you began your career shooting in a different format. How did you get that idea?
Yeah. See, actually, Sangeeta, there are a lot of reasons for somebody's work being better than someone else's. I think mine, I was just influenced and by the right people. Even when I was young, I would know that a Vijay Anand movie song will always be, I will find it much better than some Chalu rubbish song, which may be more popular. I think that, to have that innate sense of what is your taste, you know, in cinema. And though I love the full-on mad Bollywood movies, but even in that, I would tend to go towards the directors who had a finesse about them, whether it was Vijay Anand or Guru Dutt or Raj Khosla, or people like that who would do something innovative in the format. And other than that, I think I was truly blessed that when I started work, I got to work with some of the finest directors who were also innovators, whether it was Mansoor Khan, whether it was Vinod Chopra, whether it was Kundan Shah, and then later, of course, when the young breed came in, then we all were together. There was Aditya Chopra, and there was Karan and Farhan, and in fact, Dil Chahta shot exactly in the same theater, that song. So, upstairs, when they're eating the popcorn and watching the movie. So I think that I was wanting to learn so badly that I would pick their brains, all the directors I worked with. See, I never got to go to FTI. At that time, FTI was huge and I was dying to go to, but it was 3 years and there was no one to pay my fees. So I couldn't go there. So I think in a way I was compensated. I got all the people from FTI, I got to work with all of them, and they all, I got to work one-on-one with them, and I learned so much from whether it was the cinematographers from there, or the directors, the assistants, the costume people, production designers. So in a way,
shooting high speed in that time.
Yes.
No one had ever done it.
Actually, they had. People had done it.
Okay.
A few instances, even now when I see, there were some old Hindi movies and all, and a lot of it had been done in the south. But I think the way we did it was just so fresh. And so I've seen actually some songs. I've seen one Aruna Irani Cabaret, which has been done in high speed with lip sync. But the impact is not there because I used the high speed in a very different way.
How did you get that idea?
Well, that now, how do you get ideas? That's a very abstract question. It comes, you know what, for me, and a lot of people ask me, how did you get? For me, it's literally, my method is that I keep hearing the song, and as I hear it, the images of the song come. It forms, it's like a movie playing in my brain, you know. So sometimes only two will come. So I actually do my homework very well. I hear one song at least 100 times. At least by the end of the 100th time, the whole song is there, and then I write it down. I break it into a short breakdown. I wish I got that for y'all to see. It's quite a, yeah. Directors keep it with them because they've never made one in their lives. They're like, ye kya hai? Arre, ye toh likha hua hai sab. So I write the short number, I write the line that is going to be short, and then I write a very detailed description of how that line is going to be short. So it's a track, it's maybe a crane down and a track, and it'll go on a close up and she'll turn left to right. So it's that. Of course, you can go on set and you can improvise, but I have my script of the song ready with me. And then many, many Xerox copies are made of that, and they are given, distributed to people who look at it like it's...
So if we focus on where we were in Rasam,
yes, sir.
And we use all these ideas that you're saying, I mean, specifically, that we saw...
Yeah, Dol Bajne Laga.
Tell us how did that get concerted with that,
no.
Because that was very different from the previous...
Yes, actually... Till Virasat, there was a certain tag attached to me ke mood songs hai aur love songs hai na, toh ye ladki ko le lo. Wo dance numbers ke liye Saroj ji ko bulayenge ya Chini Prakash ko bulayenge. Because since then I have not done a full on back big dance number. And I have not done, aur ye khali western kar sakti hai. Why? Because I have to wear jeans and a t-shirt and go to work as opposed to a salwar kameez and a dupatta tie around my waist. Yeah. So actually Javed Akhtar, I think, was writing the song, and he and Priyadarshan was from the south. So he probably didn't know what is the politics happening here. So he was like, take her, she'll be very good. Because I had done Sapne before that for Javed, you know, Sapne. So Javed Akhtar knew that something fresh. He was the topmost lyric writer at that time. So he told Priyan. Then Priya had no idea whether I knew Indian dance or not. So I could very well have not known. But in that also, we didn't want it to be the typical filmy gaon ka gana, you know, where everybody is doing the choreograph movement and running with the dupattas. We wanted it as folky and as real as possible.
So what about that let's focus on that.
I think any of y'all are RD fans, I mean, he was absolutely, so Sanjay and me used to go, and we were like two little puppy dogs. We used to sit and we used to be like full chamchas. We used to buy cake for him every day, we used to be dada and all that like that. But he was an absolute genius. All the songs of 1942, and this doesn't really happen because normally the tune is made and then the lyric writer will sit and then he writes, fits the words to the tune. But I was there when all the songs were being, Javed Akhtar would write all the songs first. So he would write, Ek Ladki Ko Dekha Toh Aisa Laga, Jaise Khilta Gulab, Jaise, and he would just give it to Adi Barman and he would look at it, and there was no like, okay, come tomorrow, I will give you the tune. He would just start on the harmonium and he would sing the whole song without even taking 5 minutes to think that, oh, it will go like, he should just do it naturally. So I mean, he was, for that for me was like the highlight of my career.
He was at the last stage of his...
Actually, nobody knew that
because nobody knew he's going to die before the movie releases, and it was a comeback for him. Yes, he was, his career was not great. Oh my God! Yes, yes. Yes. Then I did Kabina Kabina. I'm very proud of the songs of Kabina Kabina, because that was such a shoestring budget that there was literally, there was me in the choreography team. That was it. No assistant, no nothing, no nada, everything I was doing. It does. The team is important. It's like telling a cameraman, now you have a camera and you go and shoot. There's no light man to make light, hold the light on, there's no one, no assistant to help you.
How did you manage that?
Well, luckily I met Shah Rukh and he decided he's going to be my assistant. And he still does that. So he would help out, you know, and there was no dancers. They didn't have money for dancers, so they would take local Goan people who didn't know Hindi, and they all had to sing that Chalo Bijo Hua Jaga. They couldn't sing, so Shah Rukh would make them stand in a line and practice with them, singing all of them. Yeah, it was literally like that. But I thought those were some of the best songs that I've done, because they were just so innocent and, you know, that. I think as we become more and more expert at our craft somewhere, we are that, you know, sometimes I feel that when I go, oh, I know how I'm going to shoot this song, you know, I know how I'm going to cut this song. And though that is a good thing to have a hold on your craft, but somewhere you become smart. I don't do too many songs. And I don't make too many movies. So I think somewhere that whole thing of becoming a factory hasn't happened as yet for me. Now, luckily, I'm in a position where I choose what I want to do. Or someone wants me to do a song, it's my decision. Earlier, it was like, oh my God, I'm getting a song to do, and I'm going to get paid 5,000 rupees for it. You know, let's do it. So. Dying to go to, but it was 3 years and there was no one to pay my fees. So I couldn't go there. So I think in a way I was compensated. I got all the people from FTII, I got to work with all of them, and they all, I got to work one-on-one with them, and I learned so much from whether it was the cinematographers from there or the directors, the assistants, the costume people, production designers. So in a way, shooting high speed in that time.
Yes. No one had ever done it.
Actually, there had people had done it.
Okay.
A few instances, even now when I see, there were some old Hindi movies and all, and a lot of it had been done in the south. But I think the way we did it was just so fresh. And so I've seen actually some songs. I've seen one Aruna Irani Cabaret, which has been done in high speed with lip sync. But the impact is not there because I used the high speed in a very different way. How did you get that idea? Well, that now, how do you get ideas? That's a very abstract question. It comes, you know what, for me, and a lot of people ask me, how did you get? For me, it's literally, my method is that I keep hearing the song, and as I hear it, the images of the song come, it forms, it's like a movie playing in my brain. You know, so sometimes only two will come. So I actually do my homework very well. I hear one song at least 100 times. At least by the end of the 100 times, the whole song is there, and then I write it down. I break it into a short breakdown. I wish I bought that for y'all to see. It's quite a, yeah. Directors keep it with them because they've never made one in their life. They're like, ye kya hai? Arre, ye toh likha hua hai sir. So I write the short number, I write the line that is going to be shot, and then I write a very detailed description of how that line is going to be shot. So it's a track, it's maybe a crane down and a track, and you go on a close-up and you turn left to right. So it's that, of course you can go on set and you can improvise, but I have my script of the song ready with me, and then many, many Xerox copies are made of that, and they are given, distributed to people who look at it like it's.
So if we focus on where we were rehearsal,
yes, sorry,
and we use all these ideas that you're saying, yes, with a specific that we saw.
Yeah, Dol Vajnela.
Tell us, how did that get conceptualized?
You know,
that was very different.
Yes, actually, till rehearsal, there was a certain tag attached to me, ke mood songs hai aur love songs hai na, to ye ladki ko le lo. वो डांस नंबर्स के लिए सरोज जी को बुलाएंगे या चिन्नी प्रकाश को बुलाएंगे, बिकॉज सिंस देन आई नॉट डन अ फुल ऑन बैंक बिग डांस नंबर, आई एम नॉट डन, और ये खाली वेस्टर्न कर सकती है, बाय बिकॉज आई टू वेयर जीन्स एंड अ टी शर्ट एंड गो टू वर्क एज अपोज टू अ सलवार कमीज एंड अ दुपट्टा टाइप अराउंड माय वेस्ट. या सो एक्चुअली जावेद अंकल आई थिंक वाज राइटिंग द सॉन्ग एंड ही एंड प्रियदर्शन वाज फ्रॉम द साउथ. So he probably didn't know what is the politics happening here. So he was like, take her, she'll be very good.
So that was
because I had done Sapne for before that for Javed, you know, Sapne. All those. So Javed uncle knew that something fresh. He was the topmost lyric writer at that time. So he told Priyan. Then Priyan had no idea whether I knew Indian dance or not. So I could very well have not known. But in that also, we didn't want it to be the typical filmy gaon ka gana, you know, where everybody is doing the choreograph movement and running with the dupatta. We wanted it as folky and as real as possible.
So what was different that you had to improvise as a craft? You know, how did you change? Because obviously, you have not done something like this.
No, but yeah, so see, that's when a team also comes in. So I did. My assistant was a folk dancer, you know. So I sat at choreograph with him all the folk steps because I'm very much hands-on, picking up and learning. So that's when you make a team, that you find people who are going to help you improve your craft. My team is very, it's few have changed, but my core team is there from the last 25 years. No, they are very busy. One is choreographing Miss India. And they are all celebrities now. My team. There's Geeta Kapoor, there's Siro, they're all big TV celebs.
I'm very proud of them.
So we move forward from there, and you are now obviously up to Chega Chega.
Okay, okay. Yeah, see, I think mostly what happens, Neville, is things that are truly innovative, or they just happen by chance. Sometimes I feel that there's a hand of God, what we call a destiny, that takes you there. We were supposed to shoot that song on the railway station at Ooty, and we never got permission for the railway station because the station, whatever railway ministry said, for 5 days you cannot block the station. And we had all the actors, everything, and then Mani sir said, what do we do? Shall we just do it on the train, up and down? And I was like, yes, without thinking, how can we do it, what can we do?
So that's the nature of all art.
Yes, it has to be just organic, yeah. Yes. And sometimes I think my best work has been songs where there's absolutely no budget, or there have not been resources given, or then you're forced to do come out with something innovative.
So then the idea of doing it on the train,
yes.
Obviously there's a certain risk attached to that,
yes.
Certain different techniques.
There were no, I don't know what were the techniques, but everyone asked, did you take any measures? And I said, yes, we took extra dancers with us on the train in case 2-3 fall down.
And Shahrukh was saying?
Shahrukh was wanting to climb on the chimney of the train and dance there also. He was like, I will not let anyone else ever dance on the train again, and it's true. He said, "Main chimney pe bhi dance karunga." I said, "You're going to get burned because it was actually a steam engine."
Malaika's
first. Yes, again, we approached some, I think, at least 7 to 8 heroines who all for some reason couldn't come. One had vertigo, one was getting scared, one had become very fat, one didn't have date. So literally 3 days before shoot, I called Malaika and I said, and I didn't know whether she can dance at all. No, but she did pretty good. I mean, she
did very well. But there's also another. And is this something that you sort of.
Just I, if you see most of my songs, I do not emphasize much on the chest heaving.
Any particular aspect of the body that you emphasize?
I do like hip movement because I think somewhere you have to feel the. I think all my signature moves that have become. Whatever famous or part of Indian dance culture now, I think most of them come from your core. So I like that you have to dance from your gut.
Anything particular about Vixen or that period of Farhan's creativity? Anyone wants to make any statement? Or
responsibilities, and by that I don't mean silly things like cooking and cleaning and all, but just generally somebody is there with you so that you can go and you can achieve your goal, just like you would do it for your husband. I think that is called equality.
बच्चे आपके पहले celebrity हो जाते भी, because you are also a celebrity, तो बच्चे भी आपके celebrity हो जाते हैं, तो उनके लिए उनके childhood को बचाना कितना मुश्किल होता है आपके लिए?
No, I mean today my son asked me, am I famous? So
is that important?
I don't know. He just asked me out of, mama, am I famous?
Oh, are you famous?
No, is he famous? You know that famous. So I said, right now people know you because you're our child, but later on somebody else will come who can be nobody's child and he'll become more famous by what he does. So you better get up on off your ass and do something.
From the photographs which are on the net, your son seems to be a hero in the making.
Not at all. He's writing a script.
Yeah,
he's a very creative.
No, I didn't think he was a Shahrukh Khan.
He's not a.
Of getting involved in so many songs again and again. And these item numbers which have become sort of. From Sheela Ki Jawani to Perry Kolse to Titli to Kagra to God knows.
To Mundi
Bazaar. That excites you still?
No.
So why?
It's a lot of pressure. I'll tell you why. Because I'll tell you, for a long time, I was never got to do the item song because I was always this clean cut choreographer who would only do like love songs, or I would not want to do Ranjit.
Farah, you are one of the few achievers in our industry who has not only began as a dancer, you became a dance director, then you became a director. And one more thing which you have done, which no other choreographer or dancer has done, you turned a heroine. How was that? Was it a life-changing experience for you? And why we are not seeing you after that one film?
Okay, first I'll tell you why you have not seen me after that one film. Nobody has offered me another role. That's why. Simple.
But you can offer yourself.
No, I hated the whole process. I did it because it seemed, I don't know why. Also, life is short and you should do what you feel like doing.
Any other part of the question?
But I didn't enjoy too much of waiting around. I don't know how you all do it, Gautam.
But it was a different kind of experience compared to what you do otherwise.
Yes, because otherwise I go and I'm the boss on the set. Here I'm like sitting in a van and waiting for someone to call me, and then I don't know where they're going to put the camera, how they're going to edit it. So there's no control. Now I know why actors are so insecure. Because basically they have no control in their hands. Everything is dependent on other people.
Can you answer one question very frankly? Which are the actors who you love to choreograph and which are the actors you hated to choreograph?
Let's focus on the ones you love to choreograph.
No, they want to know who I hated to choreograph. Well, there are a lot of people, of course, everyone knows I love to choreograph Shah Rukh. I like working with Salman. I love working with both these guys because the day starts by lunch break mainly. But they are fabulous on set. They are great to work with. Who I hated to work with?
Who tormented you?
Who would have the guts to torment me?
Why Rona? How was Nana?
Nana's lovely.
In Welcome? How
oh,
did
no,
you get
I made Nana do a Lavani in one movie called
Welcome, no?
I've not done Welcome. Also.
You're not done Welcome? Even Marigold is on Wikipedia.
No, Marigold also I've not done. They called me to do it. I heard the music and I said, I don't have dates. Because the music was god awful.
So someone can write to Wikipedia.
But Nana, I want to tell you, it's fabulous because he's a big bully. So if you give it back to him, he keep quiet.
Tell us what Nana's story.
Nana is trying to tell you what to do and then you have to just tell him, just do like this, then he becomes all right.
He tells you what to do in dance.
He tells everyone what to do in life. So.
Right.
I love Nana, but he's so
cute. Who didn't you enjoy working with? You don't have to say that. There's no need for that. Sangeeta had a question.
I love everybody.
What do you say?
I love everybody. So many films, acting, directing. How, as a mom now, how do you get inspiration today, in this day and age, with such a busy life?
Yeah, actually, Sangeeta, what you see of me doing everything is only like, is literally 1/4 of my life. 3/4 of my life I'm at home and I'm with my kids and I'm watching movies and I'm reading. So you basically have to go out and find inspiration. You know, you can, otherwise you can just stay with those 10-20 people in the film industry and you're just going round and round in that small little pond, which is Bollywood. But you have to start doing other things, look at other things, watch, go abroad, watch plays, watch their movies, watch shows. I read a lot, so you have to keep finding.
Did you say you drink a lot?
No, I don't drink a lot. I don't drink at all, I read a lot.
Oh, read a lot, okay, sorry. So you also like to travel. We see a
yes,
new
yes.
sense of travel.
Yes. I think travel really also inspires you. It can inspire you. You see so many things that you don't see in Lokhandwala. So.
Okay. Any other lady in the center? And then the gentleman.
Hello. First, the gentleman there.
Yes.
And then, no, first you.
Yeah.
Let him speak, then you. I'll come to you.
Yeah. Well, you know, I knew your father very well, Mr.
Huh?
Kamran.
How did you know
yeah,
him very
you
well?
You know, he was named in Kurga. I mean, he was a. He should do all. Good movies like the stunt movies, you could
yes.
say, right?
Yes.
And I've seen most of his movies. And as a kid, I used to love his movie. And I would like to tell you that his last movie, that Aisa Bhi Hota Hai.
Yeah.
What happened to it? I'm not getting the video.
That was a movie that bankrupted us.
Oh,
Aisa Bhi Hota Hai. That's when we became poor.
Oh.
Aisa Bhi Hota Hai.
That was very nice.
I know it was a good movie, but nobody went to see it. And that was a movie that literally riches to rags. That happened.
But this is a lovely line, you know, I know your father so well, and then you realize it through the movies, but that's the beauty. Now that's how India relates.
But actually, you know, Nana and Naseer, both have grown up watching my dad's movies. And they used to love them, all those.
Both of them complain about their childhood, you do know
oh
that.
Oh my God, okay.
The lady in the center there. So they. Okay, it's been passed, and then the gentleman there.
You know, that's a very interesting question because
she's asked who would she choose as a choreographer if she herself was not choreographing.
I don't know, that poor choreographer would be dead on the first day of shoot, I think.
I think there are
lots of good choreographers today, but the only thing is they're all good for various different kinds of songs. So I see like a Ganesh Acharya, and I love his work, and he's very good for like what you see Govinda do, or like, you know, that heart.
What, like the Bosco? What would you?
Bosco is my dancer actually, both Bosco and Caesar. They are also very good. So for a Western song. But I'm just happy that I, you know, because I see so many directors, and it just happens to me when I'm doing action, and that's when I realize that shit, luckily I can choreograph my own songs, at least one thing is in control, because otherwise directors are having different types of directors for different things.
But
you lose a lot of control in that, unless they are lucky to have me.
Why this lack of dialogue between classical Indian dance and mainstream Indian cinema? Why do you think we've broken down, even though Biju Maharaj has sort of recently choreographed something for which he got some acclaim, but why this lack of dialogue?
I think, Neville, the dance will follow the music. So if you have classical music still being popular and people listening to it and wanting it in the movies, you will have to do classical dance form on that. But if your music is a yo-yo Hani Singh or a Badshah, you look mad if you are doing Kathak or Bharatnatyam on it. So it's that. I always feel
but
the dance follows the music.
There's very little innovation in finding new forms.
So I think Rehman, to a great extent, did a good fusion of, not full on classical, but like
fair
good music. And so I think it all depends, because my dance will be, I can enhance the song, but finally what I get is I have to work with that.
Okay. Any other questions? Young boy there. Hello, beta.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Devansh, and the four of us are from Xavier's College.
Hello.
Welcome.
So, since you mentioned that your rise to fame in college was at Malhar, so
yes.
Do you also borrow from the college environment that you've observed in choreographing college songs like those in Mehuna or Kuch Kuch Hota Hai? Like, have you... Like,
actually, Mehuna earlier, when I wrote it, was based in Xavier's College, because that was my college. So everything was based inside Xavier's College. Luckily, our father didn't give us permission to shoot there. Only the library sequence we have shot over there.
Even the name of the college, Kuch Kuch
Hota Hai? Same thing, because my college. After they removed me for not having attendance. But
well, one second, we'll come back to you, you're not going anywhere. Swilla has been downloaded? Yes?
Later.
Yes, young lady.
One question I would like to ask. Like, my name is Amrita, and I just want to know that, like, when you started your career, means like you just now said, like, as a mother, like, you become softer and compassionate. So when you started your career and now when you have achieved so much of success, so how has it changed you as a person?
See, I'll tell you something, lot of people meet me and they say, oh, you've not changed at all. You know, which in a way is a good thing. I hope they don't mean mentally I've not advanced. But I think what happens is when you see people, including me, a lot of my, not only friends but acquaintances and colleagues, And when they get success, there is a marked change, you know. So it's a very thin line that you have to walk. If you let success go to your head, then you have to let failure go to your head also. And if you let both these things go to your head, then you're finished, because that you have to, it's very difficult, I know. But I can do it because I've seen failure at a very young age. I've seen my father go through failure. So it all depends on the kind of childhood you had, the kind of experiences you had. But a lot, if you let that change what you are and how you think and how you work, then you're not going to be a success for very long.
Also remember that our greatest learning always is our failures. What we learn in success is very, very minimal. It's based on the learnings from when things did not work for it to plan.
Did it ever depress you, the failures?
I would not say depressed, but a failure does affect you very badly. And I don't think there's any person here who says, I've had a failure and I'm fine, then you're completely moronic.
That's not true. You're sitting next to one who loves, truly, truly, without any cleverness. For me, if I did not go through 5-6 years of relative failure, I would, no circumstances, and the joy, is genuine joy, it is. Because you honestly don't see the difference between the success and the failure. We had great success, but understanding everything about life becomes so much more sensitive.
No, it does, but at that point when you fail, you do feel bad.
Why?
We have to still go to this level of nirvana.
There's genuinely no nothing, because you are what you are, irrespective of what's happening. And only that keeps you focused on your work. I'm not saying that...
But you know, we are in a creative field where basically what do you want? When your movie comes out, what do you want? Or you want people to tell you what a fab movie you made, how well you acted in the movie, or how well you danced, or I love your songs. We work not for the money, we work for the appreciation and for the feedback. And if someone says you're laughing, you're shit, obviously you're going to feel bad at that time.
Alright.
But... you have to understand why are they saying it was shit, and make sure you make
another learn from it.
Next shit, not the same one.
Yes, young lady. Speak, the mic will come to you.
Okay. Hi, Parama. As Devansh already mentioned, we all are from Xavier's. So here's a quick question. The question is, how did you manage to pull up, say, about 31 or 33 stars for that Diwangi song in Om Shanti Om, which is supposed to be the bark of item number 10?
Yes.
Okay. So how did you manage that?
See, because I was making a movie based on the film industry, and when I was younger, I used to see the movie called Naseem, where Manmohan Desai had done it, but not with 31 stars, but that was the highlight of that movie. You know, and we used to get such a high, one by one actors are coming in, and Rajesh Khanna is coming in, and Raj Kapoor is coming in. So when I was writing Om Shanti Om, I was like, listen, this is a perfect movie to put this kind of a, and hadn't been done since Naseem, which I think was in 81. So hadn't been done for almost 30 years. And of course, because it was me and Shah Rukh, and at that point, really everybody was friends with everybody. It was such a lovely 6 days. We had a party on set. Everybody who we called, unless they were out of town and couldn't come, but every single person that we approached said that we'll be there. And they all came, and either for the love of me or for the love of Shah Rukh, and or when they understood that it's a song like that. And I don't think it's going to happen again.
That gentleman who's back there, you need to come front here if you want a question. And the girl in the red. And then the gentleman who's coming forward. And then, is that Leetu who's at the mic? My God, many years.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi, my name is Surbhi. And as you mentioned that after the birth of your children, you mellowed down a little and you missed that edginess you had, the aggression which made you stand out and control things around you.
You know, my mellowness is only when I'm at home now. But once I go on the set, I realized that but to get me on the set, it takes a lot now.
So do not you like miss that extreme aggression that you had before the birth of your
children? Not really. I don't think I missed it. as such.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I think it's necessary at times to control things.
I think it's necessary at the beginning, yes. It is necessary, but you also have to change yourself with the experiences that you had. If I can't act like how I have to act when I just came into movies, I have to be screaming and shouting because I was so pressured that I have to do a good job. Now I know through experiences that if shooting ho jayegi, actor late aaya hai, lekin shooting ho jayegi. So there's a certain experience also that comes in. But if you see me on set, I'm still screaming and shouting. Maybe not as much as I was doing 30 years ago. The pressure is not there so much.
On days when you actually wanting to go back home to your children and you have that softness in your heart, and on the other hand you have to do this really tough job. So how do you maintain that balance?
Yeah, I think the balance just comes there when, you know, when you're a mom, you don't have to put on an act with your kids. You are what you are. I mean,
no, not with your kids, on the sets.
On the sets also, I am what I am.
Okay.
All right,
thanks.
The gentleman with the picture. Hello, ma'am. My name is Fajay. Since the theme of Oceanama is on womanhood, are you going to do direct a movie in near future on womanhood?
Actually, I am.
And if which Indian actress you would love to direct for that?
My script next one is with two girls in it, and it is about, it's a girl-centric film. It's, so let me tell you, it's more difficult casting that than Happy New Year's casting. Getting two girls who want to act with each other is getting to be even more difficult.
Thank you.
Are you just making a comment, or is it genuinely?
No, genuinely.
Is it that kind of conflict and incident?
Yeah.
Okay. But that's about that.
For a minute I thought it was Shah Rukh, but okay. How was it directing her in Om Shanti Om? Well, she was rather raw, and she just looked beautiful, and she had a very expressive face, but her dialogue delivery was very bad, and her voice modulation, she had a very Karnatak accent, you know, that which, so that was a bit of a problem. In fact, we had to dub a lot of her scenes in the film because it just sounded very bad. But now when I see her and what, how she has modulated her voice, I think it's somebody else who's come and do that. So that's the most difficult thing to do, to change the way you speak.
In fact, I was going to ask you, what do you think she has evolved over the years now?
Why don't I just give you a phone number?
Alright, gentleman, you had your question. Anyone else? Or the gentleman here again? You'd like to say something?
Ma'am, I want to know, out of the senior superstar or the real superstars and the newer lot, what is the difference that you observe?
What is the difference?
Which generation are you
talking
about? You're talking about the Shah Rukh Salman generation?
And the newer lot.
See, I'll tell you something. There is a great bond of emotion in the older generation. Okay, they may fight, they may become friends, but they will do that because there's genuine love. And not only between Shah Rukh and Salman, but most of the actors of that time, of like 25 years ago. The newer generation is a bit disconnected from each other. They are very professional, they all come on time, they do their job and they are emotionless about it. And
which you think affects the performance, or is it okay?
Sorry?
Do you think it affects the performance, or is it okay to be disconnected?
No, that's how they are. I think that's how they are. They are not doing it out of love. They are much smarter. The others were still little bhola and they were doing it for emotional reasons. They still do that. You know, and even if they fight because there's love and you feel bad. They show their emotions. The younger ones, there will never be great friendships or great enmities in the younger lot because they're a bit clinical about them.
But you must realize this answer if you see all the generations. You spoke to Raj Kapoor and Devanand and Dilip Kumar, and they were speaking about Shashi Kapoor and Shami Kapoor, and if Amitabh and Dharminder and Shatrughan Sinha were speaking about Shah Rukh, each of them would say the same thing. It changes over generations, It's very difficult when you have a new crop of people come along. It's difficult to judge them. It's too early to judge or pass any kind of framework. And, it's easier to talk about the Salman, Amir, and Shah Rukh relationship than whoever are the new youngsters today. Yes, the gentleman behind you, if you could just give the microphone. Thank you.
Star who is not good in dance. So how you cope up this challenge?
See, a lot of time you get stars who are not good at dancing, but I think any good choreographer will always take what is good about them and not show the weaknesses. So if I have to shoot with Ajay Devgan, I will not make him do Hrithik Roshan's steps. I will make him do something that he looks. It may not be the best choreographed dance, but he will look good doing it. So I think more or less, when I do my songs, everyone tends to kind of look, no one really look bad or, like dancing like Sunny Deol and that. Much as I love that step.
It's an essential part. Amitabh Bachchan was not a good dancer. He did certain dances based on, let's say, Bhagwan, and he kept to that. He knew, your limitations. And you then become
See, what is good for the song and not what to show off your choreographic skills at all times.
Second question, may I ask you one question is that how you think Sajid as a director?
See, Sajid has his own way of making. There's a certain comedy that only he understands and he's very good at it. If you see a Hey Baby or a Houseful or a Houseful 2, there's a mad comedy which slowly is going away, which was very popular even in Hollywood, whether it was Mel Brooks or Austin Powers. Kishore Kumar used to do that earlier. So there's a certain, now I see there's an audience that looks down upon this type of comedy. Audience is not liking it. But from when we have grown up, we used to find it crazy and mad and, there's a certain type of movie that only he can make.
Hi ma'am, good evening ma'am, this is Kavita. Firstly, you have an amazing sense of humor.
Thank you.
And my question to you, I'm a professionally trained actor. My question in precisely what my mind is thinking right now is, you just said that you're not professionally trained. I want to know what are the hazards of being professionally trained.
The hazards? I guess, see, it's a good thing if you are being trained. If you go abroad and you're not trained, nobody will ever even call you for an audition. So it's like you have to be trained. But I think the hazards are that sometimes if you go by the book, then you will only go by the book. And you will only say, I can't do this because this is not allowed. In this. So I think as an actor, there are so many who have not been trained at all and who are fabulous actors. So it has to come from within you. But I think going for a certain training, whether it's voice modulation or whether it's how to hold your body, that can only help you. But you can't be so, itna yehi karna hai because this is what has been taught to me. It's like, they teach you grammar in school. But if you are a novelist, you will write your own story. So they are teaching you the grammar of it. What you do with the grammar is up to you.
Next question.
My question is, typical, as Devil told Devil asked you, and one is Western classical.
Yes.
Means philharmonic orchestra harmonies are there, seven harmonies.
Yes.
If those things to be incorporated in our Hindi movies.
Yes.
And would you like to have choreography on them?
See, actually, can I tell you that what is Bollywood dancing? It is actually we take everything from everywhere, whether it is Indian classical, Western classical, salsa, Kathak,
and we make put it and we don't care as long as it's going on the beat and it's catchy. So Bollywood is actually, there is no such form. It's there, no one, what is this form of dance? It is being taken from everywhere. Bollywood is like America. It is full of immigrants.
But haven't we seen anything in the Hollywood movies, such kind of dancing now?
Sorry?
Such kind of dancing, we are not seen in
Hollywood movies. Like I just said, because we don't have music like that. If you do like a classical movie or a period film, you will have music like that. That also they want to make catchy and Bollywood.
Okay, let's hold the Xavier, the lady behind, then we'll come back to Xavier in a minute. Go, Peter.
Yes.
Sunil?
Peter,
why are there so many mics roaming about?
Good evening, ma'am. Myself, Devesh Vashesh. I just want to say, on the plateau of Women Road, I just said, just few minutes back, and then you
will make a movie on Women Road where you will be taking two ladies as the lead role. Now, there is a curiosity, I just would like to know, like, who you would like to take in your...
I will take whoever has dates, yeah, at that time, who will give me.
So the criteria is the date or there is some kind of taste or the new...
No, they have to be good actors also. Uh-huh. Of course, they have to be good actors.
Okay.
See, this kind of question gets us into a lot of trouble. Because we say we would like to take and there is a headline, they are already in the movie.
True.
So,
yeah, true, true, true. Thank you.
Thank you very much. The name is the bag in the pink and then...
Good evening, ma'am. My name is Zara. What I wanted to ask is that, is there any kind of a difference if it's a male director directing a film or a female director? Is there a certain kind of a difference in the entire film? What are the difficulties?
If we remove the name out of, say, Mehuna or Happy New Year, or would you know it's a female director? You would not know, exactly. If you put Karan, if you remove Karan Johar's name from a movie, what do you think a female director made it? Like, there are things which are more women-centric in his movies than a male director movie. So I don't think it's... Everyone asks that, you're being a woman, why do you make this kind of movie? But nobody asked Rohit Shetty this question, or nobody asked why he's making this kind of movie. So I think it's all in the mind. I don't think it has... A director, the gender has nothing to do with it. There are a lot of male directors who make great women-centric movies. Most of the women-centric movies that have come out have been made by male directors. Whether it's a Queen, whether it's a Kahani, what was the other one, whether it's a Piku. They've all been made by male directors. Whereas I'm making hardcore action movies like...
And if you've seen the Womanhood Festival, it's obviously there's a different sensibility that comes, which only a woman can express at times, and a man has a different sensibility. But by and large, there's I think these questions are now not that relevant in the sense of, you're first and foremost a creative person. Yeah, we are calling it quits. One last question, and then we will have a small rendition of Thriller. And let's have a question from the lady on the edge. Yeah. Xavier's has had enough questions.
Xavier's
has
wanted to do Thriller now on the stage.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Good evening. I'm actually not from a filmy background at all. I just happened to stumble accidentally into this theatre yesterday. I was planning to go for a walk. I was like, let's see, what is it all about? Yeah. And I was like, I just watched this Swedish movie. It was on yesterday for half of the movie. And I was stunned the kind of talent, and it was gripping. And today when I'm here, because of yesterday, I was wondering what I was in for. This is a totally new world for me. I'm a totally academic.
And you come on the last day of the festival, see?
I know.
You should have taken a walk one month ago.
And I just lived close by, so that's why I stumbled onto it.
No, 8:15, what?
I watched it. I want to say something because I'm an academician. And I've been always never into movies, you know. But I realize now that filmmaking is actually a science. It's an art, it's a science, the way you studied it and you know the steps to it. Why don't you introduce this into school as a subject? Because
you're the people who will teach the world. You know,
you're
the
ones.
They do have film schools. You should join one actually.
No, what I mean is normal schools. Why?
Normal schools.
Why? Why? I'll tell you why. Because movies are the thing that influence the society the maximum, and the change you seek to bring in society will be from there. So if that subject is in school, every child will know that, you know, who wants to do it, will know there's an avenue. Others, we were like ignorant. And for the first time I'm realizing that it's like this, because I've been only in academics. And the entire world is in academics. Everybody has to go to school. So if you start from there, this will be a much
See, I don't want my children to get kicked out, so I'm not making this suggestion to
This is something that Osia Nama has been working on for years.
You know, reaching a larger, not audience, learners.
We can talk about this aspect later. It takes a lot of effort from the student system to bring in film studies. Film studies usually start from the age of 16 around the world. We've been trying to push it from 12. A lot of training is required, not just for the teacher, but also for the materials which take forward the opportunity, the infrastructure. There's a lot of issues at stake. It's not going to be ready for it yet. But in time, it will happen.
Yeah, and
anyway,
I will be there.
Let's call it
Thank you.
And let's thank Faha for. I've always told I should not say Faha. What should I say? Fala. I could never pronounce my R's as a child. I had but two, and I was always accused for rabbit, and therefore probably that's the way the R.
Sounds very Mexican.
And are we going to get a little thriller rendition or?
I don't know. Everyone has to get up and.
Okay. So Farah Khan's masterclass was one of its kind, and I think I'm one of her biggest students, whom she doesn't know about, but definitely she would know. And it's very inspiring to meet such a woman who is a mother, an actor, a director, a choreographer, and has come so far in her career. And I can't help but compare her to my mother, who was separated from my father and left at a very early age. But I didn't see her with the same kind of a positivity and a great, great personality. I think this is very important for all the women to take such people as inspiration and understand that you can definitely manage your career and your family and 10,000 other things and always smile like Farah ma'am. So lovely experience. Thank you.
It's amazing to see Farah ma'am talk, and I think she has loads of experiences and years of hard work, and it definitely shows when she speaks about the creative art she's in.
Any particular question that you want to ask?
I asked her a question, since I'm a professionally trained actor, so I just asked how training really helps, and she was really nice in answering it, very, very, very good at it.
What kind of teacher is she, or what kind of human she is?
Teacher?
I mean, the human being.
See, of course, you have to be an amazing person to be in creative art, and that shows on her face, the glow shows that.
Any upcoming projects
or? Yeah, I'm doing a film with Vivansha, Akshara Hassan and Gurmeet Chaudhary, and it's slated to release in summer.
Okay, wish you all the best. Thank you.
एक्चुअली फराह खान अपने आप में एक लेसन है. इनके कोरियोग्राफ से इतना मैं एडमायर होता हूँ हमेशा, और उनकी फिल्म्स तो आप सब लोग देखते ही है. उनके क्लास से बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिलता है, और मेरी कोशिश यही रहती है कि जब भी ऐसे कोई क्लासेस हो मैं अटेंड करूँ, और मैं हमेशा अटेंड करता हूँ. लेकिन फराह जी हमेशा मेरे स्पेशल रहे, बिकॉज मी माई सेल्फ इज एन डांसर, एंड हमेशा उनके स्टेप्स देख कर मैं हम लोग कह सकते हैं कि हम बड़े हुए हैं. और मैं चाहता हूँ कि जो मैं फिल्म कर रहा हूँ उसमें भी एक बार मैं उनसे कोरियोग्राफ कराऊँ, और मैं प्रोड्यूसर से बात करूँ कि भाई आप इनसे कोरियोग्राफ करवाइए. बिकॉज ऐसे मास्टर जी मैंने एक सरोज जी थी और अभी एक फराह खान है. सो इट वॉज रियली अमेजिंग लर्निंग हर एक्सपीरियंस, द वे दे शूट एंड ऑल, बहुत अच्छा लगा.
Don't you think she should create something? I mean, something very innovative. Is it not easy or conceptual line?
कंसेप्ट लेती हैं और जैसे गुरु शांति हो गया या हैप्पी न्यू ईयर हो गया, कुछ उनको जिस मुकाम पे हैं उनको उस हिसाब से अच्छा करना चाहिए। जैसे बाउत बाजीराव मस्तानी ऐसे फिल्मों का भी दौर चल रहा है, पीरियड फिल्म का दौर चल रहा है, ऐसा भी उन्होंने सीरियस और जैसे कहते हैं रिस्क वाला कदम नहीं उठाया।
सी वैसे ही आप जैसे ओम शांति ओम इट्स अगेन सुपर हिट फिल्म, जो भी कुछ उन्होंने किया है अराउंड 80% आर सुपर हिट फिल्म्स, बट हाँ अगर कुछ अलग करेगी, लेकिन हमेशा उन्होंने कुछ ना कुछ तो वैसे सोचा ही होगा कि मैं कुछ अलग करूं, क्योंकि काफ़ी लोग आजकल अलग करने के, आज काफ़ी न्यू जनरेशन आ रहा है, तो 100% उनका भी कोई एक सोच होगी और वो 100% कुछ ना कुछ सोच के साथ डेफिनेटली आपको देखने को मिलेगा कि फराह जी ने भी कुछ अलग किया। फराह जी हमेशा एक आइकॉन रहे हैं हम जैसे डांसर्सों के लिए, कि किस तरह उन्होंने एक अपनी लाइफ को उन्होंने बढ़ाया है एज अ नॉर्मल डांसर टू अ कोरियोग्राफर एंड टू अ बिग डायरेक्टर। तो ऐसा बहुत बहुत सारे लोग हैं जिनका जिनकी ख्वाहिश रहती है कि यार हम पीछे डांस करते हैं, हम कैसे आगे आएंगे, तो शी इज़ अ बेस्ट एग्जांपल। डोंट लूज योर होप्स एंड यू आर ऑलवेज देयर। हाँ मेरे प्रोजेक्ट्स आ रहे हैं दो लफंगे, आई एम डूइंग वेरी गुड फिल्म कॉल्ड दो लफंगे, और एक फिल्म है पागलपंती अगेन, दोनों कॉमेडी फिल्म्स हैं, और ये दोनों कॉमेडी फिल्म्स इसलिए मैं कर रहा हूँ बिकॉज अब तक मैंने जो भी किया है वो सस्पेंस थ्रिलर्स और ऐसे किए, तो ये कॉमेडी फिल्म बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है बिकॉज माय मेन जॉनर जो मैंने स्टेज किए सारे कॉमेडी प्लेस से मैंने शुरुआत की थी, और ये भी एक अलग शुरुआत मेरी होगी इंडस्ट्री में। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
देखो मैं यहाँ पे आया हूँ तो अच्छा इंस्पायर हो गए हम लोगों की फराह जी को जो देख के, उन्हें इतना काम किया इतने टाइम से, 30 साल से काम किया, तो और उनका मेरा मुझे एक उनका बहुत बहुत फेवरेट ही गाना है जो मैं गाऊंगा आपके सामने। सारी इश्क की छाँव चल छैया छैया, सारी इश्क की छाँव चल छैया, सारे इश्क की छाँव चल छैया छैया, सारे इश्क की छाँव चल छैया, चल छैया 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 छैया, चल छैया 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 छैया, छैया 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 छैया, चल छैया 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 छैया। जिनके सर हो इश्क की छाँव, पाँव के नीचे जन्नत होगी, जिनके सर हो इश्क की छाँव, पाँव के नीचे जन्नत होगी, शाम रात मेरी काई रात मेरा यार बड़ा छैया छैया, चल छैया 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 छैया, छैया 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 छैया, छैया 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 छैया, चल छैया 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 छैया। थैंक यू सो मच।
आपके आने वाले प्रोजेक्ट्स कुछ इंडस्ट्री में, और ये भी जानना चाहेंगे कि फराह भाई से कुछ ऐसी आप बात जानते हो जो आप उनसे शेयर करना चाहें, उनके सीक्रेट्स भी आपने उनसे पूछे होंगे।
नहीं ऐसा कुछ सीक्रेट्स नहीं फराह मैम का, फराह मैम तो हमेशा हम तो इंस्पायर होते हैं उनसे, और उनका हमेशा जो उनकी मूवीज़ आती है जो कोरियोग्राफी होती है या डायरेक्टर जो अभी उन कोरियोग्राफ जो दिलवाले में भी आए थे, तो हम लोग बहुत एंजॉय करते हैं उनके काम को और उनके काम से सीखते हैं, और उनके जो उन्हें स्ट्रगल किया है इस इंडस्ट्री में जैसे आए, हम लोग उनको देख के हम लोग को हौसला मिलता है कि आपको ये ऐसे करना है, ऐसे मुश्किलों से चलना है, तो हम लोग उनको फॉलो करते हैं। थैंक यू सो मच।